Welcome, guys. My name is E-Dogs82, and I'm here with Warhammer Total War. Yeah. So, I've been waiting for this game for a long, long time. Years, man. I've only played actually about 3 hours on the Vampire Counts campaign. But what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna start playing on the Greenskins. So our top units is the Doom Diver Catapult, the Arachnorok Spider, and the Giant. Alright, so we got our faction leader here, Grim Gore Ironhide, an absolute beast of an orc. Or we could be Azag the Slaughterer. He has Forest Goblin Spider Riders, Orc Biggins, and Goblin Archers. Grimgor has Black Orcs, Orc Boyz, and a Doom Diver Catapult. I'm going to be Azag the Slaughterer. Yeah. So Azag is a powerful melee fighter who can also access the Lore of Death spells by unlocking the legendary Crown of Sorcery. He can unlock Skull Muncher, unique flying wyvern mount. That's awesome. So I'm gonna start the campaign. Here we go. Enjoy the cinematic.
War comes. I can smell it. World teeters on a blade's edge, but a steadying hand may yet save it. Is that my role? Alas, nothing is grand. I am merely a humble advisor to Grimgor Ironhide, the most brutal of black orcs. Even that bestial intellect recognized a moose in me. Now I accompany his horde as we travel south, laying waste to the stunted and rival orc tribes alike. Deep in the Badlands, Gorheim Rotgut, master of Black Crag, challenges his superiority. Grimgor stands to take the whole of the old world as his prize. But first, he must vanquish Rotgut and take Black Crag as his new capital.
What an epic opening, guys. Love it. Ooh. Awesome artwork there of a giant destroying the knights with all the wyverns and everything in the back. Nice. So, Azag the Slaughterer, who is the legendary lord that we'll be playing as in this campaign, is, excuse me, is actually kind of like a master sorcerer type thing. He's a what the orcs call a weird boy. He has the ability to communicate with the gods of the orcs known as Gork and Mork. And they've imbued him with great power. So he's able to do tons of damage with his magic. And I believe he's also a decent melee fighter too. So this should be rather interesting. See what I can pull out of my butt with Azag the Slaughterer. Man, this load time is long. Come on, computer, I know you're old, but you can do this, you got it. Just let me do my let's play. Nearly there. Just a little more. Come on. You got this. I can upgrade you soon, computer. Please just hold together for right now. Well, this is taking much longer than I expected. So just to catch you guys up on what happened with that cinematic, because introductions wasn't enabled, we won't actually be fighting that battle to take Iron Rock. And no, not Iron Rock, Black Crag. Yep, that's right, Black Crag. So we don't actually get to fight for Black Crag, but we will take it regardless, and that'll be our new capital on the battle, on the campaign map. So we'll be pushing out from Black Crag, taking on the rival orc tribes, and butchering some dwarves as well if we can get to them. Man, this is taking a while. If you guys have any suggestions for names of like hero units or just random units themselves, even renaming of different provinces that I take and stuff, please put them down into the comments section below. That'd be awesome. I'd love to hear from you guys and what you think. And if you have any tips or strategies for me, please also put them down there in the comments section and I'll look over it. And if I consider it a good strategy, I'll definitely follow it. Just, I welcome any support you guys can give me, because this Let's Play isn't for me, this is for you guys. It's basically just your entertainment. I'm just the entertainer, that's all. The entertainer with a slow-ass computer. I'm so sorry, guys. Load times are crazy. So I know I'm playing the orcs right now, but please, let me know what faction you want me to play next. Because I'm definitely going to play them all, but which one would you like to see the
Black
most next?
Black Flag is yours, my Brooklyn Lord. The Badlands beyond lay open for conquest. This area is dominated by tribes of inferior Greenskins. On the plains to the west, Rotguts, Red Fangs mass against you, angry at the loss of their stronghold. Proving your utter superiority over Gorfang should be your first calling.
We will.
Vanquish the Red Fang, and tribes of lesser orcs will flock to your banner, freeing your mobs to look further afield for lands to conquer. The stunted dwarfs that dwell in the mountains around you should provide plentiful quarry.
Yes, we'll be coming for
you
them
can't
too.
Can't let that black orc Gringor have all the fun. There is a reason they call you the Slaughterer. Show them all why.
Alright, we're in the campaign. So we've got a mission. Engage the enemy. We must defeat the Red Fang in battle before they are able to regain their strength. See that it is done. Alright, so we'll get 1,000 gold for doing that. Awesome. Got our mission already. I'm just going to go into the settings real quick. And wow, it is already on low. Texture quality ultra. No. Medium, please. Small unit size? I don't think so. We'll have a large unit size. Yeah, as you can see, this is the graphics stuff that I'm running with, so that'll explain a little bit as to why my computer sucks. Some of the settings may not be applied until the next time a campaign or battle is launched. Continue. Yes, please. Okie dokie. That should speed things up a little bit. Whoa. Let's resume. Okay. To business. So here is our current chieftain, Azag the Slaughterer, looking all scary-like. He's only rank 1 at the moment. He doesn't have anything much yet. Slaughterer. Wyverns is good for one thing, eating, smashing, smelling, and flying. Character's aura, leadership, plus 5. All right. So that'll keep the boys in line. We don't have anything we can give him just yet. His skills, he doesn't have anything yet either because he hasn't leveled up or anything. But he has with him some Orc Biggins, Orc Boys, Goblins, Goblin Archers, more Goblin Archers, and Forest Goblin Spider Riders. So we got a good amount of boys in the army already. So we can recruit goblins and orc boys currently. Our capital over here, Black Crag, looking very orky, I like it. The winds of magic are blowing strong here, this is good for us. So we have a capital building here, which is currently Greenskin camp. It's level 2 already. That's awesome. We have the muster fields. We can upgrade that to the brawling grounds, which will allow us to get orc arrow boys and goblin archers. We got a spare place that's open here. We can get the wolf den, which will get us goblin wolf Rider Archers and Goblin Wolf Riders. Or we can come over here and get the boss tent. The Cave of Shinies. The Idols. Or the pile of shiny stuff. I'm gonna get the boss tent, and I'm gonna upgrade this to level 2. And now I'm gonna come fight. Nash. Here we go. Come get some. So this battle is massively in our favor. They have Orc Boyz, Goblins, Orc Arrow Boyz, Goblin Archers, and Goblin Wolf Chariots. So we got this. Let's go. Hopefully this load screen doesn't take 5 minutes to load like the last one. That was bad. It didn't load like that when I was playing my Vampire Counts campaign. Jeez. I've seen a lot of Let's Plays, actually, of the Orcs already, but the funny thing is, none of them have played as Azeg the Slaughterer. I've seen so many of Grimgor Einheit. And to be fair, Grimgor is a massive badass. I understand why the others are all playing as him. But I feel like it'd be cool to explore Azeg. You know? So I guess that's why I'm playing as him. Alright, Azeg is a threat like no other. What makes him so unusual is his ominous iron crown, which emanates pure ancient evil. He's a melee expert, he's a spellcaster, and he's armored. So he is a formidable foe for anyone. I want to get a look at these spider riders. I reckon they're going to be pretty sick. Here we go. Yeah, the spider riders can like be way ahead already. So our enemies start way over here. Their chariots, where are they? I see them. They're chariot riders there. We've got the goblins. The Orc Boyz. Orc Arrow Boyz. And the goblin archers. As well as their lord, Nash, who is down here. He looks very tough, but I'll take him out. Sorry for the poor quality, guys. I know my computer's not the greatest, and this is a very amazing game. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to... what am I going to do here? I'm going to pressure my enemies here by putting my spider riders on their flank, already ready to charge at them, even though they've taken a hill. So these spider riders should do massive amounts of damage. I can't wait. Yeah, they look cool. I like that. Alrighty, back to my other guys. You guys need to all get back really quick. And then I'm going to push my archers forward so that we can snipe them off the hill a little bit. And I spread you out. I don't think so. No bother. And now we're going to put our infantry here. The goblins will go in the front to basically just take the brunt of it all. We'll put Azag over here, who looks incredibly dangerous. Oh, he's a badass and a half. Look at that. He's glowing green. Wow, I would be terrified facing that guy in the field. But anyways, let's start that battle. Let's move our goblin archers forward, the rest of our goblins. Let's get the spider riders the hell out of there because they're already moving on them. Let's move our main battle line infantry forward as well as Azek. He currently doesn't have any spells. Okay, let's move this way with the spiders, actually. See if we can get around behind them. So I'm going to get them to go, over there, and come this way, and get behind. Okay. So we're slowly moving up. We got the Orc Boyz there and the Orc Biggins. These guys are going to tear them a whole new butthole. Yeah.
Here we go. Your troops will fire at will without orders to the contrary, Commander. Have them conserve their ammunition.
Yeah. Advisor man, I know how to play, thank you. So their archers are hanging around the rear, mostly. And they're presenting their Orc Boyz at the front. Okie dokie. Yeah, let's get our goblin archers running. Our spiders are still creeping along the edge of the map. Getting ready to charge at the rear of the enemy line. Basically, my whole plan in this is to get all my goblins killed, pretty much, taking arrows in the face or swords in the gut, just as long as they distract the enemy long enough and kill some of them quick enough that I can move in my heavier hitters like the Orc Biggins and the Orc Boyz. I don't want the Spider Riders to die, though. Those guys... Those ones I like. The other goblins, though, they're very expendable. Okay, are you guys in range? Not quite. Move forward and pepper them off their hill. Ooh, here they come. They're charging. Get my goblin spears moving forward as fast as possible. Alright, let's retarget the goblin archers. Yeah, these archers are terrible. They're not very good. Nice, we got one of them. Okay, they're reshifting their lines, good. My goblin spears are moving through the line now, coming forward. Azag and his orc boys are moving forward also.
Your warriors tire, mighty lord.
Retarget their goblin spears. And send my own goblin spears charging at theirs. Okay, archers, retarget their lord. And the goblins have clashed. Their orc boys are coming into the fray. Yeah, we're losing already. Alright. Charge, men, charge. Azag into the fray. Where are my spiders at? Okay, they're coming around. Let's get them moving quick in. My goblin spears have given up. Okay, time for a sneak attack. Spiders, charge into their rear. I don't know if my gobos are actually doing any damage to their lord, but oh yeah, they're doing a bit. Just shoot the shit out of him. Excellent. We've broken them.
Your warriors begin to rally, sire. Steady their nerves and they will be able to rejoin the fight.
These goblins are going to join us. Archers, target their arrow boys. Oh, the gobos are like, no, I'm out of here, bye. And the spider riders are coming in. Oh, what a charge. Excellent. Get them, boys, get them. Alright. Archers, stop firing and charge. I want these spider riders to go after their chariots. Orc boys, get them. Orc biggins, come this way as well. Azag, where are you? Go after their lord, if he's still alive. I don't think he is, I think he's dead. Interesting. Okay. Well, come after these goblin archers, I guess. Oh no, get the orc boys. That guy is enormous. Alright, we're running them down. Spider riders. Goblins, just 10 of them. Yeah, try and get them before they leave. I don't think they're going to catch him. Nah. Come back this way then. Come after those goblin archers. So what's going down in this neighborhood? The orc biggins, yep. Go get those goblin archers if you can. Go after those guys. You there. Gobbos, come in. Nice. Everybody's on the move. The less of them that there are after this battle to fight, the better it is for me. Interesting that Azag doesn't start with any spells, considering they class him a wizard. Alright, are we going to catch our foes? And they're absolutely booking it. They're like, no, I'm out of here. Later. Yeah, let's redirect the biggins to get the boys, and the spiders to get the boys. If anything will catch them, it'll be my spider riders, because they're the cavalry unit in my army right now. Although Azag might get a piece of them too. How many did Azag kill? 9. The Gobbos killed 5, the Spider Riders 15, the Boyz killed 16, the Biggins 44, that's it. 2 for those archers and 8 for those. Yeah, those Biggins tore them up. Here we go, those boys aren't getting away. Oh, brutal. Get slaughtered. By Azag the Slaughterer. And we're finished here. There is none left except for that one guy. Oh, there's 2 of them running around still. Can you beat them to death by running them over again and again and again, spiders? I don't know. Azag, you're right there. Just cut him down. Oh, that one's dead. Use his last compadre. And super dead. Decisive victory. There we go. So we only lost 34 of our boys, and they lost 108. That's a good haul. MVPs of the army was the Biggins, definitely. We captured 17 of them. Ooh, that's nice loot. We could eat the captives, slaughter the captives, or ransom them. I'm going to slaughter the captives. Awesome, we completed our mission. We killed Nash.
Gorfang may think that his fortress at Iron Rock will provide him cover, but he is mistaken. Drive his forces out and take another of his strongholds as your own.
Okay, new mission. They want us to take Iron Rock. We can do that. What do they have left in their army? Just a couple of chariot riders and some gobbos. Nothing to be concerned about. We need to replenish, so let's try and get back into our lands. There we go, we just got a little bit back in. So we'll replenish slowly. While we're in there, let's recruit some of the Orc boys. Let's look at our technology. We don't have anything that we can do at the moment. How about diplomacy?
Relations with foreign powers may be managed.
I know. Yes, our faction is the Greenskins. And Scabii. They like us. They're a bit stronger than us.
They've left us in time. What do you want?
Let's conclude a non-aggression pact with them. There we go. Why do you like us? Ah, we've helped them before. Okay. Yep, I see. Soon enough, we'll be able to form a confederation with them. Anyways, we're going to end our first turn. Ooh, right after Azag gets a point up. Blade Master. +5 melee attack, intimidating presence, increases his aura by 5, or Route Marcher. Let's do Route Marcher, so he can move a little faster. Now we're going to end. Hopefully these end turns don't take too long. Oh, the Red Fangs are coming for us. Things do not look good for us in this fight. They outnumber us quite a bit, but they've mostly got goblins, just goblins. We could slaughter these guys, I reckon. But the computer seems to not think so. I need to patch up just a little bit, so I'm going to run away this time.
The goblins are getting lazy. You need to keep them busy, or they will get up to mischief. Build them a place of work. Within suitable facilities, the craftiest of their kind may be tasked with researching new methods of work.
Goblin's Tinker Bench. Well, I don't know where the Tinker Bench
is. Knowledge of your own strengths is vital if any conquest is to succeed. Your kind are wild and barbarous, my lord. Success will never be won around the table, but on the battlefield.
Clever guys, they got rid of my recruitment. Okay. Quickly run through that end turn again. Hopefully they don't come and interrupt my recruitment all over again. And they are. Those punks. Oh, they made me flee out of my own lands. Interesting. I'm not purposely trespassing, okay? Okay, we got the Brawling Grounds. We got the Boss Tent. Let's go forward and slaughter these last few guys. Yeah, that's right, you can't take me on. Come here. Get rid of those stragglers from our first battle. Soldiers, they're all dead. Good. Now they won't be coming forward to help their friends. Let's eat the captives. Knobnail's throat cruncher. Let's pull back to Black Crag if we can. And try to recruit some more boys. Jeez. Alright. Is there any technology we can use? No. How about our capital? Can we build anything here in Black Crag? Apparently not. Oh well. Azak has a new skill. Interesting. Ravager. Let's make him a blade master. And now let's end the turn. Hopefully these guys don't come for us, but they probably will. Oh no, they're running away. Nice. They feel that that little extra few guys that they had was not enough.
Be sure to make use of the underwear.
That they weren't having enough now to fight me with now that I got rid of that small detachment they had left. Let's go into Black Crag, get our replenishment up quicker, and let's recruit some more men. Global options are a lot more expensive. I'm not doing that. Okay, so we got four boys, we've got one big N, one Gobbo Spears, two Gobbo Archers, Gobbo Spider Riders, and Azak. Let us get some arrow boys. And how is Black Crag doing? Just fine. We can't do anything there. Let's check out our diplomacy. The Crooked Moons are a little unhappy with us for trespassing. Sorry. Let's Let's see what we can do here. Military access. Let's see if we can get that then. Okay. So the Crooked Moons Greenskin tribe does not want to have any of that business. Like, nope, I hate you.
Welcome, stranger. Stop talking.
Let's see if we can get military access with the Scabby Eye. They said no as well. Interesting. Okay. We're getting quite a bit of money at the moment. We're building up our forces. I plan on building up my forces here in the Black Crag and then marching upon Iron Rock once I deal with these punks. Mission issued. Defeat a force belonging to any of the following enemies of Bloody Spears. Dwarves or Zufba. Okay. So we got our arrow boys. Nice. We've nearly replenished. Let's get a few more goblin spears. Anything I can do for the settlement of Black Crag? Nope. Not right now. Rushing through those end turns rather quickly at the moment. Hmm. there's a lot of rival factions all around here. Okay, we've got a population surplus, that's good. We've upgraded, we've gotten our gobos with spears. Population surplus apparently isn't allowing me to do anything just yet. We need two to be able to go up to the green skin encampment. But now we're going to recruit more goblin archers. And then I will get one final orc boy. And that'll fill out the army, and then we'll be able to go kick their face in. Okay. I'm liking how quick this is going through the turns at the moment. Not like that loading screen. Oh my goodness. That loading screen was awful. Okay. One more turn, and then we can move out. Excuse me. All right, we've got our orc boys done. These are the bloody spears. We could go take them on, or not.
Azag is here.
All right, Azag, time to move out with your army. We're going to Iron Rock. How's your fightiness? They're eager, yeah? Anything I can do in Black Crag? Apparently not. Anyways, let's end the turn. I see a gold mine right there. That'll be great to have.
A rival power desires a change in your mutual relations.
Okay. Sure, I'll have a non-aggression pact with you bloody spears. I don't want to necessarily fight you. I don't have to. Alright, so, yep, we've got a non-aggression pact with the bloody spears. Ooh, we could take Valaya's sorrow, like, right now. In fact, I will. So, their defenses are small and insignificant. We're just going to kill them. Nice. We lost only 9 guys. We're going to occupy.
Your territory expands, Savage Lord. Nice. Yet there are many lands to conquer. In time, I foresee war with the greater tribes of the Badlands, as well as the stunted kind that dwell beneath the mountains. Keep your axe sharp, for Mork and Gork watch your progress with interest.
Good to know. All right. Now that we've taken that territory... Ooh, these are the Crooked Moons. They're not too happy with us. But now that we've taken that territory, we're going to move on to Iron Rock. Excellent. Ah, Azag has a point. Devastating charge. Choppers, Scarred Veteran, or Deadly Blade. Let's get a Devastating Charge. End the turn. I wish I had more options of cavalry at this point, but I don't. Ooh, if we fought a battle right here, the winds of magic are strong. It'd be great. All right.
Obedience is becoming a problem here, my lord.
No, it's not.
Those that inhabit this place begin to stir against your rule. Appease or suppress them to snuff out dissent.
Look. Let's get rid of the idols, okay? And if they're going to rebel, I will crush them. Let's go to Iron Rock. Where did that other army go that was of the Red Fangs faction? I have no idea. Anyways, anything I can do for Black Crag? Nope. What about technology? Still can't do anything. Diplomacy. The Scabby Eye really like us.
Daddy, I'll come again for our fellow greenies.
Ooh, we can make them join our confederation. Let's do that. And now we own the Scabby Eye tribe. We've become much more powerful. Great, I like that. Through shrewd diplomacy or perhaps outright intimidation, Greenskins have convinced Scabby Eye to join them. Excellent. So now we have Stone Mine Tower in our possession as well. We've got this guy here, Spike Fatbiter. He's a goblin shaman. He's cool. He's got orc boys, goblins. Ooh, goblin wolf chariots. Nice, nice. Is there anything else that you control? Whoa, how did that happen? Okay, okay. So you just had one province, I think. Yeah. But you're way out here, so... Oh, no. You also had this one. Doc Kraz. Interesting. So we're at war with you. So what are you doing in Stone Mine Tower? You should be in Doc Kraz. So we have Greenskin Camp. Oh, Greenskin Wharf. I didn't know you could get those. Goblin Watchtower. Okay, okay. I like. What about over here? We've got a Greenskin Hideout. The Mustar Fields. And that's all. Interesting. So we just picked up a whole bunch of new land, and we'll be able to unite it soon once we take over the Iron Rock. Good, good, I like it. We're expanding rather swiftly. Getting very rich. And I don't think there's anybody else that particularly likes us. Crooked Moons, how powerful are you? Not as powerful as me. Orcs of the Bloody Hand. Okay, so they rank 48. We could incorporate them into our group as well. How strong are the Red Fangs? Oh, they're weak. Thief Snatchers. They're way down there. And they're weak. Very weak. I want to try and combine as many orc factions as I can. The Top Knots. Oh man, they're the most powerful there is. They're a savage orc tribe. Interesting.
Now then, boys, speak up.
Let's conclude a non-aggression pact with you. Okay, they want me to pay for it. I'll do that. So, the top knots we've got better relations with now. Let's end our turn. Oh, the dwarves. Look at that. That was Thorgrim Grudgebearer out of nowhere. Oh, no. Oh, the city's lost. We can't defend this. Damn it. Oh, they didn't... Okay, they didn't totally wipe it out. They just raided it, I guess. They needed a little bit of money. Interesting.
Your prestige grows.
Awesome, we got this.
News of your conquest spreads far and wide. Your developing power is noted by even the most distant of kings and bestial lords.
They're unruly at the moment with their fightiness. That's not good.
Get out of here!
Facilities in this city are damaged, my lord. Repair them to gain the full benefit that they can provide.
Bloody dwarves.
An enemy port, my lord. From here, they ply trade across the water with allies on distant shores. Capture it, and you may do the same.
Yeah, we failed that mission, whatever. So this guy needs to do something. Like, he is just like...
On the way.
My men are just so angry right now. Alright, let's recruit some more orc boys for you so you can actually have some fighting power behind you. Is there anything I can do within the group itself to fix their fightiness? Yeah, let's do that. Okay. So we bashed a few heads together. Okay. Can't do anything here. Delay is sorrow. We need something to fix its public order problems. Not idols. Not pile of shiny stuff. Muster fields. Alright. That appears to be the only one that I can see that'll do it. I guess I'll do a pile of shiny stuff here then. Alright, Azek, time to raid Iron Rock. Thankful to Thorgrim for just basically destroying me. You made it an easy victory for us. We didn't lose anyone. Although we didn't get a lot of loot from it. Let's occupy that. Nice, we captured it, good.
Our Wolf Rider scouts report a force of dwarfs to the north, isolated from the safety of their hold. Slaughter them, and news will soon spread of your intent to break open the mountains.
Alright, this is the first quest battle, the Battle of Thundering Falls. This will be a great battle. Let's upgrade the settlement. We already have a muster field here, so we don't need another one in this province. How are things going over in our other provinces that we've just picked up? They're doing okay.
The tribe's ready!
Okay, you're building up forces here. Good, good. I love all the iconography of the orcs over here. This place's obedience is going down a bit. I don't like that. Not one little bit. Anyways, we're preparing for the Battle of the Battle at Thundering Falls, which is in the underway, which I haven't shown you yet, but I will in this battle to come. Let's end our turn as a skill point. Let's give him an intimidating presence. Alrighty, let's end. Thorgrim's running back to his hold. Good choice, old man. Surprised that Thorgrim's all the way down here. Ooh, the top knots are on the edge of my lands.
My lord, the enemy raids your lands and slaughter your denizens. Take up arms against them. Make them pay dearly for their transgressions.
I see them.
Awa, mighty lord.
Yes.
The bloodlust of your boys has attracted more of your kin to their banner. Your forces are unstoppable.
Excellent.
A strategic overview can be useful in such uncertain times.
Oh, the thief snatchers are dead. So we've raised a wall. Excellent. And that's a very powerful wall. I want you to go over to Barak Var. So you're going to go over there and take them out, revenge for raiding our lands. And, as it so happens, I'm going to save our game right now and end the episode. We've been playing for a while, and this is only the first episode of many. I hope you guys enjoy. And I'll see you in the next episode that I make for this. Anyways, my name is ZDogs82. It's been a pleasure playing this for you guys. I've had a lot of fun. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.
Timeless king, while you and me repeat, this bittersweet heat is suffocating. Always waiting and always hesitating. Kryptonite desires set my heart afire. Heart on fire. Set my heart afire. Mistakes ignite the silence. suffocating, hardly waiting, and always hesitating. Kryptonite desires set my heart afire.
Thank you.